We have top men working on it right now.
Who?
Top men.
There's a little matter I forgot to mention. Beware of hitchhiking ghosts.
Wait, what did he just say?
There's a little matter I forgot to mention. Beware of hitchhiking ghosts.
Okay, that was kind of creepy, but thankfully it seems like I escaped without anyone following me. You'd think they'd warn you before going in there.
Actually, we have 999 happy haunts here. But there's room for 1,000. Any volunteers?
Now, with all these ghosts, the Haunted Mansion guests all seem to have very specific favorites, like Madame Leota, the Hatbox Ghost, the opera singer, or maybe even this poor guy. Yikes. However, there are three very specific ghosts that seem to have almost a cult-like following. Phineas the Traveler, Ezra the Skeleton, and Gus Gracie the Prisoner, all better known as the Hitchhiking Ghosts. This trio has appeared on t-shirts, hats, plush toys, artwork, statues, tiki mugs, Christmas ornaments, magic bands, and so much more. And since I'm making a video about them, you know there's also some elongated coins. Which is absolutely true, and there have been quite a few released over the years. Now, most of these coins are pretty common, and even retired designs are easily found on resale markets. However, there is one set that is not so easy to acquire. On the surface, what appears to be just a regular set of three pressed quarters is in actuality a much more unique and rare set of 9 elongated quarters. Intrigued? Let me tell you all about them. One special feature of the pressed coins out in the California parks are the back stamps. Usually this back stamp is of a park logo, Disneyland, or California Adventure. Sometimes it's a shop name like World of Disney, a themed land like Adventureland or Tomorrowland, or even some infamous hitchhiking ghosts. In January 2012, back in the New Orleans Square area of Disneyland Park, a new set of Haunted Mansion-themed press quarter designs were released. Real quick, let's just take a moment to appreciate this machine's cabinet design. Sure, it's a bit morbid, but that's the type of over-the-top theming I absolutely love and wish we saw more of. Okay, back to the coins. Now I'm going to start using some reference numbers like these to help distinguish between the different coins that we're going to talk about. Now these reference numbers are actually from the parkpennies.com website, who we're going to talk about a little bit more in just a little bit. This new set of press quarters had designs of the Haunted Mansion Disneyland banner, the Haunted Mansion wreath logo, and the Haunted Mansion ride exterior. Now, if we flip the coins over, we can see that each has one of the Hitchhiking Ghosts as a backstamp. This is such a cool set, and at the time, I was thrilled to have been able to acquire it for my collection. But they didn't last long and were retired to the afterlife in July of that same year, 2012. Or so we thought. Shortly after, in July 2012, the designs returned, and to the average guest, including yours truly, I will admit, the coins appeared unchanged. However, some eagle-eyed collectors were not fooled, and upon closer inspection, it was found that the ghosts had actually hitchhiked their way onto different coins. As with the first set, this second version did not last very long and was eventually removed in October 2012. It then took nearly 6 years for the ghosts to hitch another ride, and in early January 2018, the ghosts had returned and hitchhiked to their final locations. But the spirit world was calling, and this final set was removed and retired in October of that same year, 2018. For my personal collection, I was able to acquire that first version of coins when they were originally released, but then, as I mentioned, I just didn't pay too much attention to all the changes over the years and just never noticed that that backstamp had changed. It took me quite a few years before I finally was able to acquire that third set of coins from an eBay purchase, but that second set had continued to elude me for years. I've wanted to show off this full collection of coins in a video for a long time, but kept putting it off, hoping I'd be able to someday find this last elusive set. Now, of course, I could have just photoshopped it for the video, but I hope by now you realize that's not how I want to share coins with you. I'd rather not make the video than fake it in some way. So, how did I finally get my hands on this set? Well, I reached out to Boomer over at the amazing parkpennies.com website. I let him know about the video idea I was working on and wondered if by any chance he happened to have this rare set in his collection. And if he did, would he mind if I borrowed them for a little while? Well, he quickly responded, confirmed that he did have them, and he wasted no time in shipping them over so that I could work on this very video. When I initially opened the package, the coins were safely secured in this plastic sleeve. I emailed Boomer asking if it would be okay to remove them for some photos and video clips, but understood if he preferred that they stayed secured. These were not my coins, and I was trying to take extremely good care of them while they were in my possession. But Boomer's response took me completely by surprise. He said, as a token of appreciation for all the videos that we put together and just sharing the hobby with everyone, that he was going to gift the coins to us, which honestly, I was completely speechless. It took me a little while, and I did eventually respond to him and just said there is no way I could possibly separate these coins from the rest of his collection. But he insisted, just saying that he was paying it forward for all the amazing coins that he's received over the years from running his fantastic website, parkpennies.com, and he hoped that they would hold a special place of honor within my collection. And that, I can definitely guarantee, they will. In case you aren't familiar, the completely free parkpennies.com website is owned and maintained by Boomer and his family. It is the resource for any Disneyland elongated coin collector. It includes photos, detailed descriptions, machine photos, release dates, retirement date, error coins, and so much more info available throughout the entire website. If you somehow haven't seen it before, please do yourself a favor and go check it out. It's where I go, and I've gone for many years to help with my own personal collection. I even found this old checklist from their website. As you can see, it's dated May 2008. So just a little proof that I have been using their resources for so many years. Plus, it's where I got a lot of the details about these Hitchhiking Ghost coins for this very video. Thank you again, Boomer, for your incredible dedication to our hobby, your amazing website, as well as for these coins. It's truly an honor to have them and be able to share them with everyone here today. Thanks as well to all of you for checking out this brand new series. I hope you found it somewhat interesting. I do have some ideas for other unique and rare Disney elongated coins, so be sure to keep an eye out for those in the future. If you have any ideas for rare or unique Disney elongated coins that you know about, maybe I don't, be sure to drop me a comment down below so I can look into it and maybe they'll appear in a future video. As always, keep on pressing and beware of hitchhiking ghosts. How do they do this again? Oh no, I think I did it wrong.
Did I look scared enough? All right, good. Let's cut.